وكرما وتعظيما وإجلالا وقدرا، وصل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة
نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه، ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله، أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزاناً وأفصحها بياناً، فأوضح الطريقة ونسح الخليقة، صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأولاده وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده، خصوصاً منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق، أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي، وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون، اتقوا الله وأطيعوه، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. أو مسلمز believers، الله سبحانه وتعالى with his endless mercy has granted us to be Muslims. He honored us, and this honoring is a holy honoring. When someone say he is a Muslim, means he is under these blessings, under this manifestation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy on that person. And how it's so happy to the heart that you say about yourself, I am a Muslim. We are asking that, Ya Rabbi, as you have sent us, as you have made us Muslim, make us mu'min. لا تقولوا آمنا بل قولوا أسلمنا. Allah said in Holy Quran, don't say we are mu'mins, say we are Muslims. Because iman is not yet entered into the heart. When iman enters the heart, there are some simple signs that you can see. If you have these signs, then you are really having iman in your heart. Might be little bit, might be too much. One time, Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam has a believer, and he asked him, O Moses, O Ya Musa, Ya Nabi Allah, when you go to Tur Sinai, speaking with your Lord, because he is Kalimullah, he speaks with Allah directly, I am requesting you to ask him for me to send me iman. I have no iman in my heart. I feel I have no iman. And Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, when he finished his prayers, when he finished to get the message that Allah wants him to deliver, قدت تايم قدت دي. He said, يا ربي, one of my, those who believed in me, your servants, is asking you and requesting you to send him iman. He doesn't have iman in his heart. He feels empty. Oh Allah, you are the generous one. You are the absolute, you are the absolute generous. No one can be more generous than you. You created generosity. Give him iman. Allah said to him, Ya Musa, go tell him I gave him iman. He came back, knocked at the door of his neighbor, of his student, of his, the believer, and no one opened the door. He knocked, no door is opened. He pushed the door and entered, and he find his, that man completely in complete submission. He is not feeling that Sayyidina Musa around him. He is like someone that his mind is stopped, complete coma. And he said, Ya Rabbi, what happened? He said, Ya Musa, you asked for iman, I sent iman. But I sent one small particle of iman. That small particle of iman, that it is smaller than the smallest that you can see in this dunya, I have sent to his heart. Ya Musa, if you grind him, he will not wake up. He is completely in love with me. O Muslims, iman from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even a small atom of iman, is able to make you drunk in Allah's love. So means mercy to human being, to each other, is important. If you have mercy, then there are signs of that mercy in your heart, means you have iman in the heart when you have mercy to each other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My mercy has encompassed everything. So the signs of mercy, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you can see it, you can detect it. And this will tell you if you have iman or not. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وعن جرير بن عبد الله رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه قال, جرير said that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, من لا يرحم الناس لا يرحمه الله. Who does not show mercy to people, Allah will never show him mercy. And mercy is important to take you to paradise. Allah said, according to a holy hadith of Prophet, سَبَقَتْ رَحْمَتِي عَلَى غَضَبِي. My mercy has overrided my anger. Means when you are in a state of mercy, means in tranquility and peacefulness and happiness, this is a mercy. You are not sick, you have everything, Allah gave you everything, you are in that state, you are feeling that mercy on you, you want to share it with people, Allah likes that. He said, سَبَقَتْ رَحْمَتِي عَلَى غَضَبِي. Someone who has a mercy, his anger will go down. If you want to know that you are not an angry man, you have to know that you are a mercy man. A man that can look to help other people. And that's why Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, من لا يرحم الناس لا يرحمه الله. The one who doesn't take care of people, look after them, from that ocean of mercy in the heart, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give you mercy in the day of judgment when you are in need for it. Why Allah give Prophet Shafa intercession in the day of judgment to intercede for the Ummah and send them to paradise? Because out of mercy, out of that love that it is there, that Allah loves us, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept anyone who say la ilaha illallah dakhala al-jannah. Anyone who say la ilaha illallah enter paradise. That is from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O Muslims, look, even this is a show that you have mercy in your heart, you have iman in your heart. An Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa arbah qad. Abu Huraira said, and this is, these are all authentic hadith. قبل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الحسن بن علي رضي الله عنهما وعنده الأكرع بن حابس. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting in an association and he kissed his grandson Al-Hasan, the child of Sayyidina Fatima al-Zahra, the son of Sayyidina Ali. He kissed him. And he was then one of the people, leader, his name Al-Aqra' ibn Habis. Qala Al-Aqra', he said, إِنَّ لِي عَشْرَةَ أَوْ عَشْرَةً مِنَ الْوَلَدِ مَا قَبَّلْتُ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدٍ. I have 10 children, Ya Rasulallah. I did not kiss any one of them in my life. فَنَظَرَ إِلَيْهِ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. And Prophet looked at him and he said, مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمْ لَا يُرْحَمْ. Who does not have mercy for people, Allah will not have mercy for him. So the sign of mercy, and it is a simple sign that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us, is to keep your family happy, is to show love and mercy to your children and your wife, is to keep those who are around you feeling okay, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy with you. Don't be to yourself only, looking everything good for yourself. There are other people with you, living around you, living with you and living around you in the same community. If you don't show them that mercy, then as Prophet ﷺ, he said, مَنْ لَا يَرْحَمْ لَا يُرْحَمْ. Who does not show mercy, he is not going to get mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment. وعن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها وأرضاها قالت عائشة, سيدة عائشة said, قدم ناس من الأعراب على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. A group of Arabs, Bedouin from the desert, came to visit the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فقالوا, they asked Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, أتقبلون صبيانكم? Do you kiss your children, your boys? Very important here. أتقبلون صبيانكم? Do you kiss your children, your boys? فقال نعم. And Prophet said yes. قالوا لكن والله ما نقبل. And they said, they gave oath to, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we do not kiss our children, our boys. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أو أملك إن كان الله نزع من قلوبكم الرحمة. It is not in my hand. I cannot control. And it is not in my hand if Allah took from your heart the mercy. Means you have no mercy in your heart. Show them love. Show them respect. And what the Prophet said here, you get it? Sahib? He said, أَتُكَبِّرُونَ صَبْيَانَكُمْ? They asked, do you kiss your boys? He didn't say, أَتُكَبِّرُونَ بَنَاتَكُمْ. He didn't say, do you kiss your daughters? Because there is a risk there. Because at that time, the father married the daughter married the sister married the son married two sisters. So it was a complete problem. So he wants to show that separation is important. Don't say, I can kiss this one and I kiss this one. You are a man, you kiss a man. Don't kiss a girl. Today it's completely opposite. If you kiss a man, they say it's gay. This is Muslim culture, you hug and kiss. But if a woman is stranger and you kiss her, there's no problem in this kind of communities. So they were very careful when they asked Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, do you kiss your boys? They didn't say, do you kiss your girls? Because for sure, you don't need to. You don't need that, although it's okay. No problem. But how many today we are hearing with the prediction of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam 1400 years ago? How many today we have problems, we have issues that the father is harassing his daughter, is that? Or the brother is trying to abuse his daughter in different ways. What you call assault? In English, what is the word for it? You. Assault or harassing? So, 1400 years, Prophet ﷺ was predicting that. Oh Muslims, Islam is a very delicate, soft belief that has counted for everything. And that's why the greatness of Islam, when Allah says in the Holy Quran, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنَّ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Religion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Islam. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن صفيه فقال عز وجل قائلا مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم مفخر العرب والعجم مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد. يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والكافرين إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى